Hello planning engineers. This is Hani Ismail from planningengineer.net website. The voice of this video was created by an AI voiceover. Hope you will like it. 10 days ago, I shared with you the job requirements and prerequisites for the planning engineers document. I was very happy with your interaction with this document. In this video, I want to explain this document in detail and answer some of your questions and comments about the planning engineer job requirements. So let us start with a detailed explanation of the planning engineer job requirements and prerequisites. At the end of the video, I will share the link to download the document for your reference. As you can see, the first evaluation criteria are years of experience. As we consider the number of years of experience, we should consider as well the quality of these years and their relevance to the proposed job. For example, if you have a project which is more related to infrastructure, then you should focus on those who have relevant infrastructure experience. Same for oil and gas, buildings, and special buildings such as airports and railways. Furthermore, important evaluation criteria are the size of the projects involved, who is the consultant and project manager, planning requirements, and the candidate's job role. You may find someone with 10 years of experience, and someone else with 1 year of experience repeated 10 times. Again, the quality of the experience is more important than the number of years. Finally, there are minimum requirements of years of experience. No matter how genius you are, you cannot be a planning manager with 3 years of experience, for example. However, you can shorten the years of experience from 20 years, the average, to 10 years if you are skilled enough. The second evaluation criteria is education. I received several comments saying that why Bachelor of Engineering BSc, or why Master Degree in Project Management MSc? I know someone who doesn't have a BSc or MSc and he or she is doing great. You are talking about the exception, not the rule. The main rule for a planning engineer is to be an engineer. And to be an engineer you need a Bachelor of Engineering or equal degree as per your country. I am talking here from a Middle East point of view. To be an engineer, you need to have a Bachelor of Engineering degree. Coming to the second qualification, Project Management Professional, PMP. The value of this certificate is not the piece of paper you get when you clear the exam. It tells that you understand the main concepts of project management and can understand and discuss with the client, consultant, and other contractors professionally. As I am a planning manager with 20 years of experience in mega construction projects within the United Arab Emirates, Saudi Arabia, and Egypt, I cannot accept a team member in the planning team under the senior position, 5 to 10 years of experience, without a PMP certificate. I might give him or her the chance to clear this certificate within 6 months if I found talent in other areas, but at the end of the day, for me, it is required. The Master Degree in Project Management MSc is the most debated qualification as per your comments. To be honest, I was not a big fan of academic qualifications in the construction planning field until I started my master's degree at Liverpool University. I enrolled in an online course for the master which contains 8 modules and a dissertation. It was very costly and it takes me around 3 to 4 hours daily for 3 years to complete it. In your opinion, what are the skills I gained from this program which make me recommend such a degree for section head, deputy manager, and planning manager? In my opinion, it is a long time commitment and time management. Yes, I have learned many project management skills, but the hardest thing to do was to be committed to my program for 3 years and manage my work tasks with my master's degree assignments and research. Furthermore, having a master's degree in project management helped me to draw the client and consultant's attention to my opinion during any discussion. Of course, if I am not skilled in negotiation or I am saying illogical things, no one will say but he has a master's degree. I am talking here about the first impression which will open the door for you to talk. Then, it is up to your skills to keep this door open or to close it because of your negotiation and planning skills. Now, if I am recruiting a section head, deputy manager, or planning manager, I need him or her to have such a prestige degree to open the door with the consultant and client during any negotiation. Furthermore, I will be confident that this person is accountable because he or she was able to clear such higher education. Of course, the quality of the degree matters. It is meaningless to have this degree from a poor or unknown university. Please don't say that this piece of paper is not meaning anything. Or, you know someone who has a master's degree or PhD. Degree and she or he was a very bad planning engineer. There are tons of other requirements in addition to this qualification. Just think about it from this perspective, if two engineers have the same skills, one of them has a master's degree from a reputable university, and the other does not. Which one will be hired? The third evaluation criteria are project management and planning skills. These skills are what will be examined in the technical interview. I am talking here from a practical experience where I have made many interviews with planning engineers and I have built planning teams from scratch. As I said, the academic study discussed earlier will bring you to the interview, but you cannot pass the interview without knowing how to do things on the ground. Earned value management EVM is the first basic question you need to answer. I am talking here about defining the plan value, earned value, plan percentage, and actual percentage, and how to calculate them. You might think it is very basic, but I was surprised that many planning engineers who claim they are seniors get confused about this simple thing. Critical path method, CPM, scheduling. This is where I ask about the critical path, longest path, total float, free float, and how to define your critical path in your project. Productivity rates and resources estimation. Many planning engineers are confused when it comes to resource estimation. During my interviews, I give the planning engineer the productivity rate, and the quantity, and ask him or her to calculate the budget working hours. Who fails to do this simple task is rejected immediately regardless of his or her qualifications. Work breakdown structure, WBS, and create activities list. These two questions will vary depending on the job role. For example, a junior planning engineer will be asked how to do it and what are the breakdown bases. For seniors, I am more concerned about the overall strategy of decomposing the project into smaller manageable areas. This will reflect the understanding of the actual experience. Sequence activities and create relationships. I spend more time in this area. I ask about the main activities and their relationships to find out if the planning engineer understands how the project is being executed or not. Depending on the job role, senior, manager, etc., I will focus on more details or overall strategy. Cost and resource loading and cash flow, S-curve. This is where I ask the planning engineer how they create their cost and resource loading using Microsoft Excel. Yes, I need a separate document for cost and resource calculations to be our reference later on. Accordingly, how to load the time schedule by budget costs and resources to create the cash flow and manpower histogram. Shop drawings log and procurement log. From here I start to differentiate between talented and normal planning engineers. How to include the important shop drawings on your schedule, how to include materials, and create a detailed monitoring sheet for them. Analyzing project delays and creating a revised or a recovery schedule have too many tips and tricks. This is where we discuss how to find potential delays and actual delays, how to pass these delays to the project team using a simple yet effective way, and how you create an extension of time, EOT. Which delays analysis method you will use on your EOT and why? Prepare strategies for all planning activities for projects. This is a very important skill for senior planning engineers. For example, how do you consider the scaffolding cycle among the building, area, and project? And why? How you will manage projects teams such as masonry teams, plaster teams, MEP teams, etc. What you will do if you have a resource-driven activity? Analyze engineering activities for internal and external departments. Without engineering, we cannot execute the works. What is your plan to manage the engineering activities? How you will be sure that no material or shop drawing will be delayed? What you will do if you have a delayed shop drawing or materials? Manage all communication and provide efficient feedback. This is a managerial skill. As a senior or manager planning engineer, how you can manage client requirements in terms of planning? What if the site progress is too slow or delayed on some activities, what you will do? Manage company resources among different projects. Can you put a resource movement plan for all the ongoing projects? If yes, how? A small hint here, to do this, you need to have a planning manual for all projects where activities ID, resources names, and project resource loading can be merged easily into one database. Other manual methods will not work on large projects. Direct and build planning team. As a planning section head, deputy manager, or manager, you need to be able to build and direct your team. How you will direct your planning engineers? Will you have a fixed template for all projects? If yes, how and why? When you want to hire a planning engineer, what would be your evaluation criteria? Recommend improvements and ensure the quality of all project schedules. This question should be asked to deputy manager or manager planning. Tell me, what was your most recommendation or improvement on your previous company? When it comes to the planning tool skills, we have three main tools we are using in construction planning in the Middle East: Oracle Primavera P6, Microsoft Excel, and Microsoft Power BI. In your country, you might be using other software such as Microsoft Project or Telos. But I will focus in this video on what is common in the Middle East. Oracle Primavera P6 is amazing scheduling software. You need to know how to deal with it. It is very simple, by the way, and how to import and export data using Microsoft Excel to save many hours of your work. Microsoft Excel is my best tool. I am using it while creating the schedule baseline, afterward while updating my schedule, and finally while creating my reports. Excel skills such as VLOOKUP, pivot tables, and conditional formatting will help us a lot to shorten any task and be sure that nothing is wrong with our calculations. Excel Power Queries is your virtual assistant where you can do many tasks by a simple query. It is not IT skills that require coding or knowing other advanced IT skills, it is all a matter of drop and drag. For example, using a smart activity ID system and Power Queries, I was able to create a relationship between two activities such as block works and plaster among all floors, and make it ready for export to Primavera P6 with one click. Accordingly, I would strongly prefer a planning engineer who has these skills to be part of my team. I will be sure she or he can do tasks more accurately and in a shorter time. Power BI is an amazing interactive reporting tool. You can create the report and publish it and send a link to anyone who is an internet browser to see and interact with your report. Furthermore, you can add all the company data in one report where you can drill down and see the performance of each project using the interactive solutions provided by Power BI. It is very simple, yet very effective. However, to be able to deal effectively with Power BI, Excel pivot tables, and Excel reports, you need to have an organized database. This database could be an Excel sheet or SQL database, it does not matter. What matters is how you are going to store your project's data and how easily you can grab it when required. If I am doing the database without the help of an IT engineer, I will do it using Excel. If I have a bigger company with available IT resources, then we as planning engineers can give the database structure, tables, to the IT department and they will simply do it for us. Nowadays, technology should be used in the planning field. Nothing wrong to keep learning something new every day. I always say to my team that if you don't have 30 to 40% of your time free to learn something new, it means you are doing something wrong with your daily tasks. Usually, I interfere here to see how they are doing the daily tasks and recommend automation or a smarter way of doing these tasks. I did that in the past 20 years and it always works. For example, one of my planning engineers was taking too much time updating the procurement log because the client had special requirements in coloring and highlighting the materials based on their status. We spent 1.5 days working together and ended up with a fully automated sheet as per client requirements. Instead of doing this update in one working day, after the automation, it took only 20 minutes to do the same with zero mistakes. That is why I need the seniors and managers to have planning tool skills. They should not do the work by themselves, but they need to help the team to automate and make any task shorter and more accurate. Soft skills are very important for planning engineers. The most important one is a positive attitude. I see some planning engineers who create a lot of trouble on site. They cannot smoothly coordinate with different departments. As a planning engineer, you will deal with internal and external parties such as engineering department, construction department, procurement department, clients, consultants, contractors, subcontractors, etc. You need to find a solution for each problem, not a problem for each solution. For example, the project manager requests a revised schedule within 2 days to submit to the client. This is not a logical request, but how you can deal with it? Negative attitude planning engineers will simply say no, it cannot be done. Or they might say okay and miss the deadline. Both actions are not correct in my opinion. You need to find a solution by discussing this issue with the project manager and offering alternative solutions such as, what about adding 2 more days to be able to finish the revised schedule correctly? Or saying okay, no problem, but within these 2 days, I can finish these activities, pick up the important activities, and send for client review while finishing the remaining after 2 more days? For a positive attitude, I have zero tolerance for this requirement. I might accept a planning engineer with less experience or skills and teach him or her. But when it comes to the attitude, it is tough to change. I found this from my own experience: if a person is not willing to change their attitude, you cannot change it. Soft skills can be examined during the interview by asking the planning engineer's response to certain scenarios. It is not part of my interview questions as a separate part. I just ask a few questions during the interview based on the job role and evaluate soft skills accordingly. Finally, this document was created by me from my own experience, and it is not mandatory for anyone. It is just a guideline for planning engineers who would like to improve themselves or for HR who is looking for evaluation criteria. You are welcome to put weight on each skill as you want. For example, you might think that the master's degree is not important for you so you can give it less weight, while the Oracle Primavera P6 is more important so you can give it more weight, etc. My final advice to planning engineers, try to fill all the required skills. My final advice to HRs, try to find the planning engineer with the most filled skills. If you would like to download the template we discussed in this video, you will find the link in the video description. If you have any questions, or you would like to contact me, you will find the Keep in Touch links in the video description. I hope you will find this video useful to you. See you in the next one.